this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all, as EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. The eyes of the world upon us tonight as Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis is underway. Danny Amendola on the return. Oh, able to avoid him. Tackled shy of the 35. Pretty shifty footwork, but didn't buy him much. Give him 40 on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. And now we take a peek at the Patriot offense.
I think Deion Lewis is at the NFL the exact right time for his running style. Not tall in stature, so he hides behind the offensive line a little bit. Jump cuts back there. Defenders can't find him and have a hard time getting him down. Catch the ball in the backfield and has an extra ability to return kicks, which also causes a lot of problems for the opposition.
And a glance now at the Chiefs' defense.
Derek Johnson entered the NFL as an outside linebacker whose game was built on speed. In recent years, though, he's remade himself as a strong inside linebacker to take on blocks and plug the running game. He hurts him.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 26. Brady and Edelman hook up for a big one. 41 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They go play action here on first down. And this is caught. It's Edelman. A good pickup there. 26 yards.
What a catch and one-handed. And I'm starting to lose my awe about the play. And maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
And those gloves, they do have a little grip to them.
They get that little extra tackiness to them now. And I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Matt Brady again. Oh, it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball first down in this situation, because second down,
that's caught by Gronk for a Pats touchdown. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl, and the Patriots drive right down the field and score on the opening drive.
Brandon, this is the Super Bowl. A touchdown scored in any game is big, and this one is massive.
Now Steven Goskowski on for the extra point. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. Goskowski now out to kick it away. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. And he's got room. So now the Chiefs go on offense in a great starting spot. Here's a man in his 13th year out of Utah, their quarterback, Alex Smith, the former number one overall pick.
And head coach Andy Reid has said, even with Patrick Mahomes being picked number 10 in the draft overall, people think he's going to replace him. Alex Smith is our guy, and he should be.
A heavy rush, and down he goes. Jay McClellan coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
But that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack.
He's going to take in that situation. In this case, not only does he take the hit, he coughs the ball up, as you know.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Solid running on the carry, but still brought down just inside the 40. Credit it with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You better also just sit back during the throw it on every down.
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 7-0 is our score. You are watching the NFL on E. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. They're staring up at a 3rd and 9 to start it out. Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. Losing 9 yards there. And it also brings up 4. In his 5th year from La Tech, here's the lefty Ryan Allen to punt it. Tyreek Hill back deep for Kansas City. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. No return, but it goes down as just a punt of 31 yards. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a 1st and 10. On 1st down, Smith. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They come after him, they sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep the offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. A reminder coming up at the intermission. We'll get highlights of the Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Now Smith, caught here by Conley. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City 1st down. Here's Smith. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Shane McClellan in there to get him his 2nd sack now in the afternoon. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
On 2nd down, here's Smith. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he'll get it up to the 34-yard line. A nice pickup there, 19 yards. And they're set up better for 3rd. 3rd and 2, Smith. And leave this for Ware. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. To throw to Smith. Caught by Tyreek Hill. The Chiefs now going to use the 1st of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the 1st half. Now a 1st down throw. It's Smith. Complete. This is Albert Wilson. Now another timeout call points to go in the first half. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
Intentional defense.
A little eager there coming in from his outside linebacker position.
You think the hard count got him there?
Yes.
And maybe that extra hut, you know, that extra emphasis on it. Got him to jump and then picked up 5 yards.
To the air again, Smith. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw them. We can throw them well with a whole lot of confidence. This close to the goal line, you got to be very careful with the offense calls rub routes. When I call a pin trying to screen you off from your coverage, does a nice job of avoiding that and helping force an incompletion.
It's a good one. Now, everything here, we're going to get a timeout by the offense as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Now Smith on third and goal. A strong running. And it is incomplete. Stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Not sure what you're thinking here, partner, but I believe the officials have done a nice job here getting together and then coming out and indicating that there was a receiver in the area.
Absolutely, and he was in the area. Correct call made. No grounding. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a field goal here. They're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
Oh, now he bowls them over. So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring 51st Super Bowl. I know when I joke about you guys skipping halftime, sometimes you get frustrated, but this is the Super Bowl. You got to watch the halftime show of the Super Bowl. All right, let's get you to the third quarter. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Tyreek Hill set to return it. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I've been guessing in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive. Well, guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage is coming through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down in that run.
And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13.
So statistically, both of these offenses have a rough time getting the running game going.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right, you look at the numbers. Neither side looks on track in the ground game. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Throwing on third down, Smith. And he'll win it over the middle. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big 30-yard play on third.
A lot of receivers see the drag route as a risk-reward type of a play. The risk, going into the middle of the field where there's some big people want to hit you. But the reward is oftentimes you get lost in coverage. Running a little bit underneath, and when you catch it just right as we just saw there, end result could be a big, big play.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. But winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. You're watching. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Chiefs with a football, but with work to do on the scoreboard, they trail as we start quarter number four. Now Smith. And this is going to be incomplete. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides. The tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
That one good for seven that time. And the Chiefs are going to have a first down. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You stop to get it done as you noted, and they did.
Back to throw, Smith. Oh, no, he lost the football. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Back to throw. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on. Yeah, that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
The right side complete to Escobar. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. He's back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four. So this defense, they looked a little shaky to start the drive, but bottom line, they're a play away from finishing it off.
They rocked them a little bit on this drive, didn't they? But as you and I both know, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. They have a chance to end it right here.
He'll look to throw, and no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Patriots defense is going to take over on down. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on down.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Brady gonna throw here. And this is gonna be caught. He won the fight for the football. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look.
Wait.
And they'll take a knee as the clock runs under a minute to play. Here's Ryan Allen now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And possession will change here with very little time remaining in this contest. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. But he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed it. Instead, second down. So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you got to be prepared for everything. Like the laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
And it's another Super Bowl title for the New England Patriots. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that holds the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey, and now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.